30, essentially.
Yeah, that's fair.
Is that it? It does really well with spacing and with a player like Ippo, very rushdown heavy. He's working on incorporating a lot of just patient play.
Okay.
You know, he's not throwing out as much blade beams, but just the fact that limit charge is so fast, he just uses that as a threat. That's a threat in its own, because obviously you don't want Cloud to get limit.
No, that's just scary.
That's just like that. You know, 1 + 1 is not 1; it's 2. 1 + 1 is 2. You know, obvious things. We're messing around here.
Yeah.
But you know, Ippo is definitely, you know, Ippo is the bigger like rushdown player.
Is this right?
No. Yeah,
okay.
Exactly.
CSA.
He goes tag first, then character.
That's smart.
Yeah, but we're going right into it here, guys. Winners round 4, Ippo versus Jewel here, guys.
All right, so here we go. We're gonna. Is the game audio there?
Just one of the things that we're just not used to. Game audio.
Okay. Yeah.
So no big deal here, guys.
Yeah,
the chat can hear it. Stream can hear it.
All right. Cool. Sorry.
No big deal, but an 89% combo to start things off here. Ippo, I don't know if Ippo has many Robin matchup experience, to say the very least.
I talked to Ippo before. This is his first time ever playing against Jewel.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is completely new to him.
I know I think he might have played against Amarellus, who is a dual main of a Bayonetta and Robin, but...
But Jewel is definitely the stronger player when it comes to the two. So
when it comes to the two, yeah.
Let's see how Ippo could do against his improved Robin over the past few months.
Of course, yeah, and the improved Cloud also going with those buffs. I'm not sure,
Ippo is yet to get a hit. It's just, you know, hard for him to get in.
Yeah.
And where we're going to...
He had his limit there at that moment. So let's see. All right, he gets his first swing in and tries to go for the...
it's still possible to get a JV4, I'm just saying.
Yeah. Oh, and catches the up air right now. Ippo is just kind of just like swinging forward with his head. Like, yeah. I think like the major thing he just needs to do is just weigh out some of these options, learn what like some of these buttons can do, and then from there maybe you can safely... There you go.
Yeah, there you go.
Up B out of shield. I think he's playing a bit sloppy today. He has been saying like, yeah, I think I'm playing a little bit sloppy like to my standards, but... Okay.
Barely missing that F smash.
Yeah. All right. Going for the Nosferatu. Tries to read the roll towards Jewel. Now he's got limit. Oh, ooh. No. But he has his jump.
He does have his jump, and he's going to live.
He's going to live.
That's going to burn the limit, and that just sucks for Cloud.
Yeah, it does. But, hey, that thing's charged in 5 seconds. So, you know, like...
That's just good now.
Yeah, exactly. Like, the fact that he can do that, that's, like, 2 seconds off this 5 second, like, feel. He's just trying to chase after him, and again, like, yeah, Ippo's not playing to the best of his ability today, it looks like.
No, he's definitely playing really sloppy. You know, he's not playing as, you know, defensive when it comes to it.
Again, this could just be the matchup unfamiliarity.
Oh, definitely, yeah, I'm not, you know, doubting Ippo at all. Just
yeah. All right, tried to get clip something with the limit cross slash. Because the other thing, too, is that Jewel's getting a lot of clean combos, too. It could just be, it's not just like Ippo playing sloppy. Oh,
the falling down up air is going to be able to take out Ippo.
Yeah. Yeah, along with that, it's not just Ippo playing like a little sloppy, too. Jewel's like on point with these conversions, essentially. So.
Yeah, good start for
It's a good start Jewel. For Jewel. Yeah. I don't know what like else to think of for when it comes to this this matchup, like what Ippo can possibly do.
Maybe I'm not, you know, trying to call my shots, but maybe a character switch. I mean, I'm not saying like I'm not sure.
I don't think he really has a character that he can like fall back on.
I mean, I think he has a Sheik.
He has a Sheik, but he definitely doesn't like utilize it as much.
I mean, it is possible, but it's very unlikely. See, they're talking something out.
I think there's we do allow coaching during our locals here, so there could be a little bit of coaching going into play. Yeah. So I'm not sure. I think that was Sage who's actually coaching him now.
Yeah, Sage did walk out, so I'm assuming he's giving some advice to Ippo.
He better, because if that game starts and there's no one here, I mean, I know how to run a stream, but I'm not putting on this headset. You hear the sound of a headset being dropped?
That sucks.
Yeah, I'm not
giving any examples.
Yeah, it's not good for stream. Jewel looking directly at the camera.
is my headset volume good, by the way? Do you want to move the mic closer?
Move it a little bit closer. Yeah, okay. Always like keep it like a little closer.
Is that good?
Yeah, you should be fine. Here, I got it.
Thank you.
There you go.
All right, thank you a lot.
That's better, yep. All right, so yeah, going into this, Ippo is a fan of running it back here. Hopefully, there we go. That's very good.
This is some of the momentum that Ippo needed.
Yeah.
And here we go, still continuing it.
Like, at least, like, let's see if he can, you know, now he's just playing, like, Wi-Fi style, but at the same time, you know, like,
I mean,
that's the Ippo.
Yeah, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Yeah, Ippo plays very heavy rushdown. Like, I know, like I mentioned before, yeah, he's trying to experiment with, like, you know, playing a bit more defensively, but there you go. He has the item. Great throw out.
He went deeper. I'm assuming Jewel went for the uppy spike there.
Nah, I think he just wanted to disrupt it, maybe to try and clip him out of the jump, but yeah, the spike definitely is an option.
True.
Ooh.
And again, that limit is at halfway now.
Yeah.
And getting so much from that back here.
He is. Oh, great.
The F-tool. This is what Ippo needed. This is the momentum he needed for the rest of the set.
Exactly. Now, see, now Ippo is like definitely getting his footing down. And here, you know, he's getting, like I said, he's getting his footing down along with that. He's just pushing himself further and further. Great nair, though. Classic, you know, that's something definitely, like, you need, like, a couple of, like, games to, like, realize. Like, you know, side B, arc fire is really effing good at the ledge. So
yeah, everything checkmates, honestly.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And you know, air. great like knowledge there, like and just like great, just like spacing here.
Yeah, I mean, he definitely is utilizing the spacing a lot more than he did last game.
Yeah.
You know, Jewel didn't really give him a chance, so good for him.
All right, try and go for an early spike, trying to steal a little bit away from here.
Ooh, the good cross slash gonna be able to catch him. Not gonna kill yet though. Throwing the arc fire back out on the stage.
Again, there you go. There was the patience that Ippo needed from last game, and now it's starting to work a little bit. So yeah, like one of the biggest things. Oh yeah, he also does play against Zoya the Sapphire, who's predominantly a snake main, but does have a secondary with Robin.
Oh, okay, so.
So
yeah.
Like, very little matchup experience. Oh my God, almost caught the roll there, but just mistimes the up smash. Definitely would have hit through the platform.
Yeah, that move is a lot. Ooh, not yet. That was a good DI.
Hits the back air, and Sage, could you update the score, please?
Oh, yeah,
it's Jewel. Yeah, it's Jewel. All right, good stuff.
A little bit of a DBZ, but Ippo is going to be able to live. It's going to be able to live.
Yeah, he's able to live their forward throw. You know, the L Thunder is going to kill at the ledge. Of course, those arc fires are no friend to anyone. He has Levin Sword. That Nair is going to take it. It's going to be a real match here. There we go. Ippo definitely making a lot of the adjustments that he needed, though, to make this match a bit more of a game, you know?
He did 52 from one up air. That was incredible.
Thank you. That's what runs in, like, that little crew of Jewel, MGW, and Venya. These two, like, are just insane with just making something out of nothing. Like,
yeah, I can respect that.
Yeah, like, they get conversions, and they play it around. All right. Here we're seeing, you know, Ippo, like relaxing a little bit with the limit, but unfortunately,
I think, did the timer run out?
Yes.
Okay, I was
15 seconds was on the clock. Going for the big F smash, not gonna steal a game just yet. Gets the Nosferatu, and now he's at kill percent. I don't know if he has the Levin Sword. He does manage to air dodge
but
away.
Now it's gone. He's gonna be use it as projectile with the thunder or the arc thunder.
Arc thunder coming into play. Yeah. Whoa.
Bit of spaghetti, but the 3-hit jab is gonna send Ippo off stage. Throwing out the arc fires at the ledge, trying to get that nair to maybe end the game.
Oh,
end
no.
Down throw? No, forward
no,
throw.
Forward
okay.
throw.
Okay.
He has 3 hits left on the Levin Sword. He has the spaces out correctly. Great arc fire. I think he has Nosferatu back. I think he has arc fire.
But Ippo has limits, so this can be good for either of them.
Oh, no.
Misses. Back throw, I assume. Yep.
Yep. And,
he's
but
still
no.
living.
He's still living at the ledge. It definitely would have killed, though. Arc fire,
ooh,
and
that's
then
it.
Thoron's going to take it. All right, though, last thing I got to say about this, you know, is that, like, while it wasn't 2-0, you know, a pretty, like, bad start from Ippo, if I can be completely
definitely
honest, he managed to make the adjustments in the end that actually managed to keep him up. He managed to, like, switch up between the rushdown, managed to, like, just like, use the threat of limit. I feel like that's what a lot of, like, players seem to forget when it comes to, like, a character with, like,